Bioweapons. Bioweapons are commonly known as germ weapons, and when we talk about the germs, it can be in the form of bacteria, viruses, rickettsia, or fungi, because they have the ability to cause disease in human beings, plants, as well as animals. So bioweapons are actually the disease-producing infectious agents which are used against the living organisms. That can be human beings, animals, or plants. Now, bioweapon is not only a practice of today, but it is an ancient practice used in warfare, and it can cause mass destruction, thus responsible for more deaths. Now, here deaths can be due to diseases. जैसे कि कुछ अर्सा पहले पाकिस्तान के पंजाब प्रोविंस में डेंगी बहुत कॉमन था, यानी कि पैंडेमिक था. It is believed that dengue virus is a bioweapon in Punjab province of Pakistan. Now, there are three types of bioweapons. Apart from germ weapons, there can be bioweapons in the form of chemicals, radiological weapons, or nuclear weapons. Now, all these type of bioweapons can be used in military applications. Now, we use the term mass destruction with bioweapons. So this is something very confusing. Keep in mind that bioweapon is responsible or capable of mass deaths, while it is not capable of mass destruction of buildings or of equipment. Now, the infectious agents that are considered as germ weapons, they can cause anthrax, brucellosis, smallpox, or viral hemorrhagic fever. Then the toxins produced by infectious agents can also act as bioweapons, such as staphylococcal enterotoxin B, botulinum toxins. So there is a list of such infectious agents that can act as bioweapon. अब बहुत सारे germs ऐसे हैं जो कि disease humans में या animals में या plants में cause कर सकते हैं, but they are not considered to be bioweapons. Now, if the term bioweapon is used for any infectious agent, then we have to calculate their lethality, stability, length of incubation, and the bioweapons should be untreatable by medicines or vaccines. So, on the basis of lethality, stability, length of incubation, and untreatable by vaccine, we can consider them as bioweapons. Now, a number of precautionary measures have to be taken when we are dealing with the bioweapons, because most of the bioweapons are in the form of aerosols. वो हमारी सांस की नाली के जरिए हमारे लंग्स तक पहुंच सकते हैं. So we have to wear masks which is equipped with special type of filters, and these filters can filter out small size microorganisms, even viruses. Then we have to overgarment ourselves by wearing boots, gloves when we are dealing with the labs of infectious agents. In the same way, we can prevent the contact of wounds with the infectious agents by covering those wounds with special sunny plast or with any other dressing. So now, in the military buildings or in the labs, biological weapon sensors are there. We can use them for our own safety and for the safety of our country as well.